Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Core Harpreet. Today my topic is questions from previous papers, in which I will give their explanation also to justify my answer. As you know, on my regular basis I'm posting videos on various periods of English literature, but my today's video is on question answers, in which I will give answers with explanation. And this video is for my those friends who are appearing for next coming UGC. So I hope you will like my effort, and so let us start with the video without wasting any time. My first question is, she dwells with beauty that must die, wrote Keats in one of his odes, referring to number one ode on indolence, autumn, melancholy, or psyche. My answer is Ode on Melancholy. It is the shortest of Keats' odes. The first two stanzas are in which he is offering advice to the sufferer, and in the third he explains the advice following a scheme of A B A B C D E D C E. The rhymes of the 8th and 9th lines are reversed in order from the previous two stanzas. The three stanzas of the Ode on Melancholy address the subject how to cope with sadness. The first stanza tells what not to do. The sufferer should not commit suicide. In the second stanza, the speaker tells the sufferer what to do in place of the things he forbade in the first stanza. In the third stanza, the speaker explains by saying that pleasure and pain are interlinked. Beauty must die, joy is fleeting, and the flower of pleasure is forever turning to poison while the bee mouth sips. The speaker says that the shrine of melancholy is inside the temple of delight, but that is only visible if one can overwhelm oneself with joy until it reveals its center of sadness. Coming to next question. Question number two is, the anatomy of melancholy is a reflection of human learning and endeavor, published under the pseudonym. Four options are given, and my answer is like this. The anatomy of melancholy by Robert Burton. The English scholar, writer, and Anglican clergyman Robert Burton is best remembered for his The Anatomy of Melancholy, written under the pen name Democritus Jr. This work is a masterpiece of style, a mine of curious information, and a valuable index to the philosophical and psychological ideas of the time. It was published in 1621 and expanded and altered in five subsequent editions. In the first part, he discusses its causes and set down the symptoms. The second part is devoted to its cure. Love melancholy is the subject of the first three sections of the third part. Then the fourth section deals with religious melancholy, and on the cure of despair, he rises to heights of wisdom and of meditation. He influenced other writers in England, including John Milton and Charles Lamb, in the 17th and 19th century respectively. My third question is like this. Arrange the following literary periods in order in which they appeared. Use the quotes given below. First is Elizabethan, second Caroline, third is Anglo-Norman, and fourth is early Tudor. And quotes are given. A, option A is third, then second, then fourth, and first. According to quote B, third option comes first, then fourth, then second, then first. Option C is like this. Second, third, fourth, first. And option D is third, fourth, first, and second. To give the right answer of this question, firstly, I will read periods of English literature for you. I've already made a playlist on chronology of historical events or literary works of English literature. This playlist will be very helpful for you, because in this paper, question is asked from the from Old English period, and the question may vary from period to period, and that playlist will be very helpful for you. You must go to channel and watch that also. Let us start with the answer. Periods of English literature are like this. 428 to 1000 Old English period, then 1000 to 1350 Anglo-Norman period, then 1300 to 50 to 1500 to 50 Middle English period, then Renaissance period is 1550 to 1650. In Renaissance period, there is Elizabethan age, Jacobean age, and Caroline age. 1650 to 1600, the Commonwealth interregnum. Then 1660 to 1790, the New Classical period, in which there is Restoration period. Augustan age, the age of Johnson, and the time periods are also given. Then 1790 to 1870, the Romantic period. This includes the age of Romantic triumph, the early Victorian period. Then 1870 to 1915, the realistic period, in which falls the later Victorian period and the Edwardian age. 1915 to 2000, 20th century literature, and 2001 onwards, contemporary English literature, which will be the topic of my next video. Then question number 4 is, conventional scholarship dates early modern English as beginning around. It means early modern English starts with or begins around from 450, or option B is 1066, option C is 1500, and option D is 1800. My answer is like this. All languages tend to go through phases of intense generative activity, during which many new words are added to the language. One such peak for the English language was the early modern period of the 16th to 18th century, a period sometimes referred to as the golden age of English literature. Distinctions are commonly drawn between the early modern period and late modern period. And my question is related to early modern period, and the answer is from 1450 to 1800. This is my answer. Why I'm giving these explanations? So that it will be easier for you to remember, because it is very important to know the basics or know the previous years. It will be easy to learn. So early modern period is the answer, and late modern English period is from 1800 to the present. The early modern English period follows the Middle English period towards the end of 15th century and coincides closely with the Tudor and Stuart dynasties. The early modern period was transformative for both England and language. It was a time of revolutionary development and opening for English to become a worldwide language. So friends, this is all about my today's video. I hope you will like my effort, and if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. And if you are new on my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications from my upcoming videos. And this is my URL. You can directly go to my channel, and this will be very beneficial for you. And must check the chronology playlist. It will be very, very helpful for preparing your exams. So I hope you will like my videos, and thanks a lot for watching.